Yeah, we were gonna do my bachelor party there, but we were afraid that with our skill level we would get kicked out. Yeah, we had some casualties and some. I've been to club. I hit a tree with it.
In real life, this happened?
Yeah,
Oh,
Thursday.
okay. You did get kicked out.
We didn't get kicked out. We went to Orleans, so they're a little bit more relaxed and not
Oh,
as.
I see.
I had a caught a root in the ground because we played in the woods a lot, and
Did
yeah.
you?
Leave the Christmas lights up till January. This is our place, we make the rules. And there's a dazzling haze, a mysterious way about you, dear. Have I known you 20 seconds or 20 years? Can I go?
You're late.
That happens every now and again.
You look very beautiful.
Thank you. You look handsome.
Thanks, I tried.
I styled it all up. I got a whole bunch of stuff everywhere. I got coins in my shoes. I got a whole bunch of stuff right here. Stuff in my bra.
I love you.
Love you.
We could let our friends crash in the living room.
Okay, you can turn around. Thank you. What do I do now?
Welcome everyone to this happy celebration. We are here to celebrate love, friendship, and family. This past year has been a class clarifying experience for all of us about what is important. And a testament to the strength of the love between these two people. Today, we are honoring their relationship, the journey to this day, and they're going to start a new journey forward as a married couple. We are here to unite two families into one community, drawn together by their love. Dearly beloved, you are invited here today because you're important to this couple. You have given them encouragement and love over the years, and you're important to them, so that's why you're here. Marriage is a serious commitment, and life is not a predictable journey, as demonstrated by Molly here today. There will be challenges along the way. This is normal for all married couples. Sometimes these events are small, and sometimes a little bit more challenging. You, my dear friends and family, are here to form a circle of love and support around this relationship. Your role is to offer encouragement and compassion wisdom and insights, reassurance and comfort, and to remind them when they need to hear it of all the good qualities that they've mentioned to you about each other. Remind them of all those happy times where you've seen them laughing together, and just give them the encouragement that they need. I'm gonna ask you now to respond, "I will," to the following questions and show your support for their relationship and become part of the circle of love and support. Will you respect their marriage?
Yes. Yes.
I will.
Will you foster love in their relationship?
Yes.
Will you help them keep their sense of humor about marriage?
Yes.
And will you celebrate with them today and all the days into the future how much they love each other? I have a little poem by Heather Berry, "The Promise." Within this blessed union of souls, where two hearts intertwine to become one, there lies a promise, perfectly born. Well, we got a little nature for effect, dramatic emphasis here. Perfectly born, divinely created, and intimately shared. It is a place where hope and majesty of beginnings reside, where all things are made possible by the astounding love shared by two spirits. As you hold each other's hands in this promise and eagerly look into the future in each other's eyes, may your unconditional love and devotion take you to places where you've only dreamt, where you'll dwell for a lifetime of happiness, sheltered in the warmth of each other's arms. We are here to celebrate your love for each other and to unite your lives in marriage. Today, you're marrying your best friend and the person you're in love with, the person who understands you just by looking in your eyes. You are meant to be together, balancing each other's strengths and weaknesses, acknowledging that what makes you different and unique is also what makes you stronger together. Think back to the day you met. Remember when you realized what an incredible person you'd found, the excitement of the potential between you, and how you wanted to spend more time together, sharing your thoughts and talking, and to be connected in the deepest way. Always carry that spark of realization in your heart. Keep it burning brightly with your generosity and kindness. Cherish your spouse by making their happiness your top priority. Give them the best you have to offer. Put them first before anyone or anything. Your vows today are to not let the busyness and distractions of the world make you forget how lucky you are to have each other. Your promise is to take care of each other and show your love daily, even if it's a small gesture. Leave no room for doubt that you love each other and that you're committed to each other. Today, your entrance into marriage is saying, "I'm so glad I found you. I love you. I trust you, I value all that you've brought into my life, and I'm looking forward to this adventure with you as a married couple." Your marriage is your home. It's your sanctuary from the world, a place where you can breathe easy and be yourselves, a safe place to be comforted in your times of struggle and sadness, a space to relax and be vulnerable. Protect this place and treat it with care. Fill your home with laughter and kind words. Make it a place to build on your close friendship. And focus on what truly matters to the two of you, like you're doing today. So Preston and Desiree, it's my responsibility as a justice of the peace to make sure that you want to marry each other. And I think your wedding dress is a tip-off. But I must ask, please respond yes or I do, whatever is right for you. Preston, would you like Desiree to be your wife?
I would.
And Desiree, would you like Preston to be your husband?
I would.
I'm going to ask you to share your vows. And Preston, I'll have you go first.
Desiree, when you and I first met, I was hanging out at your family's campers with your cousin Billy. The second you arrived, you just complained about all the new people you had to meet. So me being me, I stood up and shook your hand and said, "Hi, my name is DJ." And you turned. In return, I got a "Hi," and you slammed the camper door in my face. We hung out for the duration of the fair. Then we dated for a bit in school. Our personalities could not be more balanced. I am spontaneous and impulsive. Our trip to Canada for Mexican food. And you're a planner. And everybody standing here beside us will attest that we all received a checklist of what we had to pack and the itinerary for the day. As I look into your eyes, I promise to be the one who calms you on a busy day, the one who holds you on a sad day, and will celebrate with you on happy days. And I promise you will hear "yes, dear," once or twice. Not because I'm annoyed or because I'm a pushover, but because love is better than a fight over something small. I would promise to never go to bed mad at each other, but you always make sure that never happens. No matter what time of night or what time I have to wake up in the morning. As I was trying to figure out how to end the vows, I remembered Carmen said to end with something funny. So here it goes. My feelings, with some help from Dr. Seuss. I love you, Desiree May. I love you every day. I love you holding your bouquet. I love you here at Jay. I will love you when you're old and only crochet all day. I love being your fiance, but today we get to say I do. I love you, Desiree.
PJ, I knew from that August week all the way back in 2012 that you would become my husband someday. The sparkle in your eyes when you are about to say something you know is going to cause a reaction continues to cause me suspicion but also melts my heart, just like it did that first night at the fair. I'll never forget walking to my camper complaining about all the new people I had introduced myself to at field hockey, and then out of nowhere you walked by and said, "Hi, I'm PJ, nice to meet you." I rolled my eyes and shut my camper door. I'm so happy you kept talking to me, even after your first impression of me being Moody Desiree. Because I could not stop talking, thinking about you. This was also the exact reason I knew you were the one, because Moody Desiree isn't all that fun and you came back. I love the laughter you bring into my life every day. You are the mellow to my madness. I've never met someone as patient and kind as you, and I'm so thankful for that quality, because I think most people would say they've never met somebody as impatient as me. You make life feel safe for me to take risks and push me towards my dreams and our dreams. I love you with everything inside of me. I can't wait to go through the rest of my life with you as my husband, partner, and best friend.
Let the power of your promises strengthen your relationship and carry you through the challenging times. Let your words of love be your guide and give you the courage to be honest and compassionate partners. May you use each other's strengths as if they're your own, and together be loving and joyful for the rest of your days. Can we have the rings? So these rings are not only for the couple, but they're a reminder to all of you. When you see them on their hand, remember that you are part of this circle of love and support that they want in their life, and they're going to need as a couple to have a long and happy marriage. And for the two of you, it's important to remember when you look at your ring that it's a reminder that you have a responsibility to each other. That your responsibility is to create a life and a relationship that brings out all the qualities that you love about each other. So when your spouse is not being that person, do what you can to create an environment that will bring out the best in them. So if you would repeat after me as you put this on Desiree's finger. Desiree, take this ring.
Desiree, take this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
And when you look at this ring.
And when you look at this ring.
Remember this day.
Remember this day.
This moment.
This moment.
And how much I love you.
And how much I love you.
And now, Desiree. Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And when you look at this ring.
And when you look at this ring.
Remember this day.
Remember this day.
This moment.
This moment.
And how much I love you.
And how much I love you.
So, to celebrate the uniting of their lives, they're going to do a sand ceremony. And so, I'll invite the couple to step up here. These two separate containers of sand symbolize each of their lives. Each grain in the container represents elements of what makes them who they are. Their experiences, their values, their humor, their ideas, their talents, their dreams, their life lessons. Today, through marriage, we are joining your lives together with love and trust, bringing two families together with hope and determination, with openness and acceptance. As you can see there, as I mix in here, they're doing this wholeheartedly with the passion for a successful marriage, knowing that their lives will be as easy to separate as it would be to separate these grains of sand. By blending the sand, they acknowledge this and welcome the adventure of their new life together.
Lovely weather chaotic day in the sweet bar. Good evening.
That's right.
For those of you who don't know me, my name is Julie. I'm Desiree's daughter.
I got you.
Father, excuse me. Today we're celebrating the beginning of Desiree and PJ's journey as husband and wife. I'd like to take a moment to thank all of you for being here on their special day. I would especially like to officially welcome PJ into our family, along with his parents, Peggy, Scott, Preston, and Tanya. Anyone that knows me knows that Desiree is my pride and joy. Some would even say I was a bit overprotective of her. I may have been. But that was because I only wanted the best for her. Today I look at her and know that I did the best that I could, because I know that she is truly happy, and that is all I've ever wanted. PJ, it is now time where I'm supposed to officially welcome you into our family. Excuse me, but the truth is, you have been a member of our family since the day we met. So it's official, you're stuck with us. In all seriousness, I am honored to call you my son-in-law. At this time, I would like to have everyone raise their glasses and join me in wishing Desiree and PJ a very happy future together.
You're acknowledging Brayden, Ingram, and Molly, Chronicles of Rickmere. It is my pleasure to announce Mr. and Mrs. LaCrosse.
Well, I found a man stronger than anyone I know. He shares my dreams. I hope that someday we'll share our home. I found love. carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand. Be your girl, you'll be my man. And I see my future in your eyes. Well, baby, dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, while listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect.
I don't.